I just needed to just grab the camera and be like, listen. And just, I just went at it. But that's basically what happened. So here, I'm going to share my results with you right now to just show you what just happened to YouTube. It just went, absolutely psycho, right? Look at what just happened. It just went from nothing, 3 minutes, 9 minutes, 0 minutes, 10 minutes, 2 minutes, to whoosh. 17 hours and 2 minutes.
Just from being crazy on the camera?
Just from being crazy on the camera.
The title, the theme here, it's Connection.
Welcome to Love Connection, where old-fashioned romance meets modern-day technology.
People just wanted to watch this. My next.
You know what's really funny is my friend Dave Kelso. I know he's watching the Hangout right now because he's talking to me on Facebook, but that's exactly what he's sharing with me, is that, like, that's why he's so irreverent. Like, he has a YouTube channel called Paradigm Shift and Educational Comedy. I mean, if you haven't seen it, go check it out because it's pretty funny.
It's too vague to suffice what I'm looking for here, but what my dad told me is that it's connection. So here we have connection.
What the hell?
Here's something that I've been contemplating for a long time, and it's just kind of gnawing at the back of my brain.
So I turn to run, but it's not too long. There's a zombie chasing me, moving his hands like... Stumbling around like, got my hands up, but not for too long. You know I'm trying to get away. Zombies and they're eating brains.
But like, his channel is just so irreverent, and he is swearing, and he's even like, the funny thing is he's just not afraid to be so crazy and irreverent. Even in a circle of people who are super spiritual. I mean, so he faces a whole bunch of flack and shit from people, but there's a reason he has, like, a million views, you know? It's because he has this crazy, irreverent humor, and just, he's, like, psycho on camera, but, I mean, he's so entertaining to watch and listen to, and that's why. And that's kind of clicking for me right now. Like, that's why people... actually cool. Want to view things. It's because it's so ridiculous, right?
It is. We've got to do the crazy. I mean,
as you've probably seen on one of my posts where I'm awake, but I'm tired and my inhibitions are gone. So here I am on a video. But I found the third ball. I've seen Austin Powers. I know it exists, and I found it. It's in there, and here I am.
Yeah, baby, yeah!
So... my question, one more thing. First world problems. I have my notes typed up on my iPad.
Editing is all Mac-based now. I mean, you know, there are programs out there on the PC, but whether you're using Avid or using Final Cut Pro, you're working on a Macintosh. Using a Mac is a little different than using a PC. It's not so much operating a computer as it is sort of tricking it, fooling it into doing what it is you really want it to do. You kind of have to sneak up on a Mac. I don't feel like I'm operating the Mac so much as I'm just there sharing the Mac experience. And if I can do something useful while the Mac is willing, so much the better.
Another app, but I can't multitask while doing a video.
One of the coolest features of the Macintosh is it's really easy to shut down. All you have to do is be using a piece of software and then poof, it goes away. It's gone. It's shut down. You didn't push any buttons. You didn't close. You didn't even save. It's just gone. Unless you want to shut down a Mac. Oh, that's a whole nother story. I mean, you try to close a program and it locks up, and then you do that funny, what is it, the cloverleaf period thing?
These unnatural and ultimately useless interrupt key.
Yep, so I have no notes. And my hard drive crashed.
Then nothing moves. Then you push the power button and it won't turn off. You go around and unplug it. And you better hope you're not on a laptop, because then you gotta find the damn battery and try to pull that out, or the thing will never shut down. So I put my CD in the CD-ROM tray, and I'm copying media off that CD, dragging it onto my desktop, dragging it onto my desktop, dragging it onto my desktop. I eject it, and where did my files go? It's the only operating system I know of where click and drag does not mean you actually copy or move anything. No, you're just making shortcuts on your desktop. So I've got my next CD, and I slam it into the CD-ROM tray, and lo and behold, it starts playing all by itself. I'm looking for a way to turn it off. Finally, out of desperation, I click and drag the CD into the garbage can. The system locks up. So I go to the cloverleaf period spacebar thing, hoping I can stop the program, and I get a little caution window saying, careful, interrupting this program may lock up the system. I try to click OK, but the system's already locked up!
What? I know everything about computers, and my hard drive just crashed. It's today. Woo!
I like the handle here. That's so you can attach a chain and use it as a boat anchor! The Mac is practicing some kind of bizarre psychological warfare on me, because I'm working late at night, and at the corner of my eye I keep seeing this thing jumping up and down. The update manager is bouncing at the bottom of the screen like a Jack Russell fucking terrier! So I'm looking around in the list of the files, trying to find the executable it wants me to update, and if I click on any one of them by accident, I rename it! Oh no, it's been renamed nothing. It was some kind of important system file, and the computer crashes! On a PC, no data is really lost. I mean, there's a way to undelete a file. If you know what you're doing in DOS, you can go in and recover anything that's been corrupted. On a Mac, if you lose a file, you run to the store, you get a copy of the Mac version of Norton Utilities, you run back only to have Norton go, "You idiot! You own a Macintosh! The file is fucking gone!"
Gone, so I can't print them off either. So, I got, like, this little one sentence written down right here.
It's just gone! Don't have any tools or any kind of buttons or whatever dials or switches in the bottom of the screen, because if you reach for them, the dock menu comes up. You've got to, like, angle around and slide and dodge the thing to get to the control. It's kind of like boxing with your computer. I can put it on the bottom, I can put it on the left, I can put it on the right. No, I can't put it on the top. That's reserved for the mighty Blue Apple. Gah!
My name is Hunter Kressel, I'm an editor, and I cut together everything you saw tonight on a Macintosh. Mac killed my inner child.
And it's just kind of a question, and I was hoping it just kind of let me kind of flow what I'm thinking of out there for what I want to do. But it's just kind of like when you go to the doctors, and you just hear, well, I'm going really off topic here, but anyway, where you just have to, like, keep telling your story to each doctor over and over and over again. So what happened? Well, I hit my head and blah, 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 blah. All right, next time. Well, so I hit my head, but, well, I kind of, and it just kind of...
Ain't nobody got time for that. 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 Ain't nobody got time for that.
It kind of turns gray and mushy, and it's out there. But it's just kind of, you don't have the details anymore, because you've, like... You've exhausted them away, so I've just kind of had this too much going on. And I finally got this video going. And, well, the balls to get this video going. So I've like, had practice rounds, I've written it all down, I've looked at it, thought about it. So it's kind of turned to the gray mush. But let's... Okay. So the question is, why do we seek relationships? And that question is pretty vague. Let's try a different one. Why do we seek relationships with someone to call your significant other? Alright, now I have this question because... Wow, this is where you need notes. Because I do not remember. Give me a moment, it'll come to me. Just have your laughs and giggles and shit. Okay. I need more in a sentence. Great notes. Good job, Justin. Good job. Yep. Alright. So, let me just backtrack here. Wow, this is going to be like a really raw video. Especially since I can't edit it. So, alright. So, connection. Alright. What is it we are seeking when we find somebody and we call them your significant other? Why is it that suddenly you find this person and then all of a sudden, instead of them being your friend or a colleague or an acquaintance, they have to be yours? And then with that, you're willing to take all this extra baggage for no apparent reason, and apparently it's more special when you put a name on it instead of when you just treat them as your friend or an acquaintance. Why the heck is this? And it's kind of... it's kind of just been back there, because for me, everything needs to have a rhyme, it has to have a reason, there has to be something going on with it. And it's just one of those things where it's just irrational and it's stupid. And it's just kind of there, and it's one of those things where somebody just beat me down and tell me how it is, or something, you know. Because, yeah, because. I really wish I had better notes. That's because. I need my notes.
And cut.
And cut?
Yeah.
I don't have scissors, I just have a shovel.
You can press stop.
Oh, okay. But it doesn't say stop, there's just this red button.
You can press the red button, Dave.
I can?
Yeah.
With that?
Yeah.
With this?
Hey!